penetration of the origin of suffering, of the things to be realized that they must be realized, that is, penetration of the cessation of suffering, and of the things to be developed that they must be developed, that is, penetration of the path. Hence it is said, what must be directly known is directly known, what has to be developed has been developed, what has to be abandoned has been abandoned. And that, Brahman, is why I am enlightened, SN 558. 27202 Besides, he has discovered all things rightly by himself step by step thus, the I is the truth of suffering, the prior craving that originates it by being its root cause is the truth of origin, the non-occurrence of both is the truth of cessation, the way that is the act of understanding cessation is the truth of the path. And so too in the case of the ear, the nose, the tongue, the body, and the mind. 28 And the following things should be construed in the same way, the six bases beginning with visible objects. The six groups of consciousness beginning with eye consciousness, the six kinds of contact beginning with eye contact. The six kinds of feeling beginning with the eye contact born. The six kinds of perception beginning with perception of visible objects. The six kinds of volition beginning with volition about visible objects. The six groups of craving beginning with craving for visible objects. The six kinds of applied thought beginning with applied thought about visible objects. The six kinds of sustained thought beginning with sustained thought about visible objects. The five aggregates beginning with the aggregate of matter, the 10 caraoenas. The 10 recollections. The 10 perceptions beginning with perception of the bloated, the 32 aspects of the body beginning with head hairs, the 12 bases. The 18 elements. The 9 kinds of becoming beginning with sensual becoming, 6. The 4 jhanas beginning with the first. The 4 measureless states beginning with the development of loving kindness. The 4 immaterial attainments. The factors of the dependent origination in reverse order beginning with aging and death and in forward order beginning with ignorance, cf. xx.9. 29 Herein, this is the construction of a single clause of the dependent origination, aging and death. Is the truth of suffering, birth is the truth of origin, the escape from both is the truth of cessation, the way that is the act of understanding cessation is the truth of the path. In this way he has discovered, progressively discovered, completely discovered, all states rightly and by himself step by step. Hence it was said above, he is fully enlightened because he has discovered all things rightly and by himself, 26.7. Endowed with clear vision and virtuous conduct. 30 He is endowed with clear vision and virtuous conduct, vijjacaraoasampanno equals vijjahi caraoena ca sampanno. Resolution of compound. Herein, as to clear vision, there are 3 kinds of clear vision and 8 kinds of clear vision. The 3 kinds should be understood as stated in the Bhayabherava Sutta, MI 22F, and the 8 kinds as stated in the Ambaþþha Sutta, DI 100. For there 8 kinds of clear vision are stated, made up of the 6 kinds of direct knowledge together with insight and the supernormal power of the mind-made body. 31 Virtuous conduct should be understood as 15 things, that is to say, restraint by virtue, guarding of the sense faculties, knowledge of the right amount in eating, devotion to wakefulness, the 7 good states 8 and the 4 jhanas of the fine material sphere. For it is precisely by means of these 15 things that a noble disciple conducts himself, that he goes towards the deathless. That is why it is called virtuous conduct. According as it is said, here, Mahanama, a noble disciple has virtue, MI 355, etc., the whole of which should be understood as given in the middle 50 of the Majjhima Nikaya. 203 Now, the Blessed One is endowed with these kinds of clear vision and with this conduct as well, hence he is called endowed with clear vision and virtuous conduct. 32 Herein, the Blessed One's possession of clear vision consists in the fulfillment of omniscience, PSI 131, while his possession of conduct consists in the fulfillment of the great compassion, PSI 126. He knows through omniscience what is good and harmful for all beings, and through compassion he warns them of harm and exhorts them to do good. That is how he is possessed of clear vision and conduct, which is why his disciples have entered upon the good way instead of entering upon the bad way, as the self-mortifying disciples of those who are not possessed of clear vision and conduct have done. 9. Sublime. 33. He is called sublime, Shugata, 10, a, because of a manner of going that is good, Sopogamana, b, because of being gone to an excellent place, Sundarai. Hanagatata, c, because of having gone rightly, Samagatata, and, d, because of enunciating rightly, Samagatata. A manner of going, Gamana, is called gone, Gata, and that in the Blessed One is good, Sopho, purified, blameless. But what is that? It is the noble path, for by means of that manner of going he has gone without attachment in the direction of safety, thus he is sublime, Shugata, because of a manner of going that is good. B, and it is to the excellent, Sundara, place that he has gone, Gata, to the deathless Nibbana, thus he is sublime, Shugata, also because of having gone to an excellent place. 34, C, and he has rightly, Sama, gone, Gata, without going back again to the defilements abandoned by each path. For this is said, he does not again return, go back, to the defilements abandoned by the stream entry path, thus he is sublime, he does not again return, go back, to the defilements abandoned by the Arahant path, thus he is sublime, old commentary. Or alternatively, he has rightly gone from the time of making his resolution at the feet of Dipayakara up till the enlightenment session, by working for the welfare and happiness of the whole world through the fulfillment of the 30 perfections and through following the right way without deviating towards either of the two extremes, that is to say, towards eternalism or annihilationism, towards indulgence in sense pleasures or self-mortification, thus he is sublime also because of having gone rightly. 35, d, and he enunciates 11, Gadadi, rightly, Sama, he speaks only fitting speech in the fitting place, thus he is sublime also because of enunciating rightly. Here is a sutta that confirms this, such speech as the perfect one knows to be untrue and incorrect, conducive to harm, and displeasing and unwelcome to others, that he does not speak. And such speech as the perfect one knows to be true and correct, but conducive to harm and displeasing and unwelcome to others, that he does not speak. 204. And such speech as the perfect one knows to be true and correct, conducive to good, but displeasing and unwelcome to others, that speech the perfect one knows the time to expound. Such speech as the perfect one knows to be untrue and incorrect, and conducive to harm, but pleasing and welcome to others, that he does not speak. And such speech as the perfect one knows to be true and correct, but conducive to harm, though pleasing and welcome to others, that he does not speak. And such speech as the perfect one knows to be true and correct, conducive to good and pleasing and welcome to others, that speech the perfect one knows the time to expound. MI 395. Thus he is sublime also because of enunciating rightly. Knower of worlds. 36. He is the knower of worlds because he has known the world in all ways. For the Blessed One has experienced, known, and penetrated the world in all ways to its individual essence, its arising, its cessation, and the means to its cessation, according as it is said, Friend, that there is a world's end where one neither is born nor ages nor dies nor passes away nor reappears, which is to be known or seen or reached by travel, that I do not say. Yet I do not say that there is ending of suffering without reaching the world's end. Rather, it is in this fathom-long carcass with its perceptions and its consciousness that I make known the world, the arising of the world, the cessation of the world, and the way leading to the cessation of the world. 'Tis utterly impossible to reach by travel the world's end, but there is no escape from pain until the world's end has been reached. It is a sage, a knower of the worlds, who gets to the world's end, and it is he whose life divine is lived out to its term. He is at peace who the world's end has known, and hopes for neither this world nor the next. SI 62. 37. Moreover, there are three worlds, the world of formations, the world of beings, and the world of location. Herein, in the passage, one world, all beings subsist by nutriment, Paisai 122-205. The world of formations is to be understood. In the passage, the world is eternal or the world is not eternal, MI 426, it is the world of beings. In the passage, as far as moon and sun do circulate shining 12 and lighting up the four directions, over 1,000 times as great a world. Your power holds unquestionable sway, MI 328. It is the world of location. The Blessed One has known that in all ways too. 38 Likewise, because of the words, one world, all beings subsist by nutriment. Two worlds, mentality and materiality. Three worlds, three kinds of feeling. Four worlds, four kinds of nutriment. Five worlds, five aggregates as objects of clinging. Six worlds, six internal bases. Seven worlds, seven stations of consciousness. Eight worlds, eight worldly states. Nine worlds, nine abodes of beings. 10 worlds, 10 bases. 12 worlds, 12 bases. 18 worlds, 18 elements, Paisai 122, 13. This world of formations was known to him in all ways. 39. But he knows all beings' habits, knows their inherent tendencies, knows their temperaments, knows their bents, knows them as with little dust on their eyes and with much dust on their eyes. With keen faculties and with dull faculties, with good behavior and with bad behavior, easy to teach and hard to teach, capable and incapable of achievement, cf. Paisai 121, therefore this world of beings was known to him in all ways. 40. And as the world of beings so also the world of location. For accordingly this world measures as follows. One world sphere 14 is 1200,000 leagues and 3450 leagues, 1,203,450, in breadth and width. In circumference, however, the measure of it all around is 6,300,000 and then 10,000 in addition. 402 less half 100, 3,610,350. 41 herein. 2 × 100,000 leagues and then 4 nahudas as well, 240,000 this earth. This bearer of all wealth, has that much thickness, as they tell. And its support. 4 × 100,000 leagues and then 8 nahudas as well, 480,000 the water resting on the air. Has that much thickness, as they tell. And the support of that, 206. 9 × 100,000 goes the air. Out in the firmament. And 60,000 more besides, 960,000, so this much is the world's extent. 42 such is its extent. And these features are to be found in it, Sinaru, tallest of all mountains, plunges down into the sea. Full 480,000 leagues, and towers up in like degree. 7 concentric mountain rings surround Sinaru in such wise that each of them in depth and height is half its predecessor's size. Vast ranges called Yugandhara, Isidhara, Karavika, Sudasana, Nemandhara, Vinataka, Asakaoa. Heavenly breezes fan their cliffs agleam with gems, and here reside the four kings of the cardinal points, and other gods and sprites beside point 15. Himalaya's lofty mountain mass rises in height 500 leagues and in its width and in its breadth it covers quite 3,000 leagues, and then it is bedecked besides with 480,000 peaks. The Jambu tree called Naga lends the name, by its magnificence, to Jambudapa's land, its trunk, thrice 5 leagues in circumference, soars 50 leagues, and bears all round branches of equal amplitude, so that 100 leagues define diameter and altitude. 43 The world sphere mountains line of summits plunges down into the sea just 280,000 leagues, and towers up in like degree, inringing one world element all round in its entirety. And the size of the Jambu, rose apple, tree is the same as that of the Citrapalia tree of the Azura demons, the Cymbali tree of the Garua demons, the Kadamba tree in the western continent of Aparagoyana, the Kappa tree in the northern continent of the Uttarakuras, the Sirasa tree in the eastern continent of Pubavidha, and the Parakataka tree in the heaven of the deities of the 33, Tavatiisa, point 17. Hence the ancients said, the Pali, Simbali, and Jambu, the deities Parakataka, the Kadamba, the Kappa tree and the Sirasa as the 7th. 44207 Herein, the moon's disk is 49 leagues across and the sun's disk is 50 leagues. The realm of Tavatiisa, the 33 gods, is 10,000 leagues. Likewise the realm of the Asura demons, the great Avasai, unremitting, hell, and Jambudapa, India. Aparagoyana is 7,000 leagues. Likewise Pubavidha. Uttarakuru is 8,000 leagues. And herein, each great continent is surrounded by 500 small islands. And the whole of that constitutes a single world sphere, a single world element. Between this and the adjacent world spheres are the Lokantarika, world interspace, hells. 18. So the world spheres are infinite in number, the world elements are infinite, and the Blessed One has experienced, known, and penetrated them with the infinite knowledge of the enlightened ones. 45. Therefore this world of location was known to him in all ways too. So he is knower of worlds because he has seen the world in all ways.